So, Angie and Amy, do you feel, you know, when you come to nursery that it's got a happy atmosphere for you as parents and for your children when you perhaps walk through that door in the morning?
Definitely, yeah. I mean, I had lots of trouble with Adam in previous places, but he's settled really well here, so he's obviously really happy to come in.
And do you feel sort of welcomed as a parent? I know we try and do that welcome at the door if we can. Yeah,
definitely, yeah.
Do you feel possibly in reception? I know it's a bit different in reception, Amy, but again, it's something we're working on at the moment to try and improve that sort of key person role in reception, because I appreciate it's 30 children and, you know, but I think it's that's something we're sort of working on. It's a bit more difficult in reception class, isn't it?
It is, yeah. I mean, every time I've had to speak to Mrs. Barrett about anything, she's always, just come in quickly and somebody else has took over letting the kids out of the door. So they're always available to talk to if you need them.
Brilliant. Great. So do you feel that as parents you're encouraged to be involved in sort of nursery planning and what goes on in the nursery and also nursery events, thinking about newsletters, thinking about planning sheets that we use?
Yeah, informed, aren't we, of everything that's going on and if we want to help, or like on trips you ask for parent helpers and things like that. So I think, we're always pretty much involved in what's going on.
Yeah. So I know we've got some of those planning sheets. I know that they've been sending out because we've been doing Kipper's Toolbox.
Sure.
So do you think those are helpful for you then if you're talking to the children at the weekend? You can perhaps jot down any notes.
Yeah, I mean, it's really nice to know what they're doing, and quite often children of that age are not that forthcoming in telling you what they're
degree.
Up to.
Yeah.
So it's quite nice to know that so you can sort of prompt them.
Yeah. Real, because we do use whatever comes back in, we do use your ideas that if you've been talking to John to feed into the next week's planning or that week's planning. So that's what we do and that's what we hope we do in it. Brilliant. What about being informed and involved in the development, you know, so their sort of progress in perhaps first in nursery and then perhaps in reception? Do you feel that, I know we do sort of, you can chat in nursery any day, but we also do those sort of more formal review meetings once a term.
Yeah.
Do you feel that works well for you as parents?
Yeah, it's nice to have the book.
Yeah,
the profile
well,
book.
Brilliant. Because quite often, like, Adam's dad can't always come
yeah.
because he's at work or whatever. So it's nice that I can go through it with him. And like you say, in nursery it's great because you can, if you have any concerns, you can just speak to them every day if you want to.
And again, I suppose linked with that, you've already said really, I think, that staff share verbal information and written information with you, so you always get a written report, don't you, from and you'll get one in the summer from reception. So really thinking about the key person role, the person that are in the three rooms and the three groups in nursery, do you think that works well for you as a family so that you build up relationships with certain people in the nursery? So that it's always, you go and you do your planning in there and everything with them, the children.
Well, it worked well for me with Kyle. I think he settled really well with Mrs. Brown, who's Mrs. Fakes. But obviously he's got no siblings, so I won't be able to carry on that relationship.
No.
But if I see her about or in the school, I always say hello and she asks how Kyle is. And so they are really good.
So that works well.
Yeah,
and for Adam and Lacey, definitely. I mean, it's not been so bad with Adam because we haven't had the issues.
No.
But certainly with Lacey, Mrs. Evans helped a lot.
Yeah.
You know, tackling her behaviour and things like that. So that was really, really helpful.
I think it's nice having that same person there as much as you can every day, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, they know the children and they know you and you know them really well. Again, that's what we're trying to develop in reception, so that we've got in Mrs. Barrett's class as Mrs. Barrett and Mrs. Hodgkiss.
Right.
And what we'll work... No,
Riley.
Mrs. Riley. No,
yeah.
Mrs. Hodgkiss with Miss Rance.
Yeah.
And what we're trying to do is build up that role of it so they take a bit of responsibility for a group. So if you as a parent want to speak to them, they will then be doing the observations on the children that we're feeding. So that's something we're working on. And what about transition, you know, when the children moved from nursery to reception, did you feel as parents that you felt involved in that process, thinking of the meetings we had and the days we had when they visited?
It was good. Kai would have just gone in and done a day
before we started,
a day straight away, no messing, no mornings or afternoons, because he was totally ready, but for the younger ones...
Yeah.
It probably did work really, really well as a slow process, building up to it rather than just chucking them in at the deep end.
And did you feel before they even started that you had, I mean, I know we did a couple of sessions in the hall.
Yes.
In the information.
The meetings,
did you feel that was just to give you a, you know...
Oh, yeah, that was really informative.
Yeah,
really
good.
And I think because because you've got Open Door as well, and they're at the nursery, that made it so much easier because they already kind of knew what to expect.
Yeah, they do.
So that was good.
And I mean, the key person as well, when we do Open Door, we make sure as key persons like Julie's, Mrs. Evans comes through into reception, and the reception staff come through to nursery, so we swap staff so the children feel comfortable in moving between the two rooms. I mean, the other thing, we use the part-time because obviously, as you say, they're very young children, and we have quite a few children external to school that we didn't know as well. We know our children well, but as far as we were concerned, that worked well. And I know some parents had some reservations about that because of, like you said, they would have stayed all day. And for staff, it worked really well because it gave them a chance to get to know those children really well.
Yeah.
So, anything else? You know, I'm just talking about partnership with parents, and we're just hoping. Is there anything you think we could do better? We could improve upon? Now's your chance. I think it is developing the role in reception a bit more, is my sort of aim. Mm.
I don't think you're as involved once they go into reception.
No, I would agree.
As we are with the nursery.
No.
But then you have to kind of respect that they need to start developing their independence. You know, we spend that time with them, settling them down in nursery every morning, and it's kind of like bye-bye at the door they go into reception. But, that you know, they need that because they have to get ready for...
And having seen them, they're all very independent now. I mean, what has worked well is them being on the nursery playground for that first term.
Yeah.
But now we open the gate. So now what they're doing is the gate's open and both playgrounds are open so they can go out. But they've always got the security of coming back.
Kai has ventured onto the playground. Yeah. He has told me he's been on there.
Well, quite a few of them have said they wanted to. So we sort of responded to them, really. And so what we do is put one member of staff on the big playground and one in nursery so that they can go between. And some of them will go and have a little 5 minutes and come back.
Yeah.
Which they've still got that security. And that's working quite well with a view to them obviously going onto the big playground in the summer term.
Right.
So that they're ready for year one. That's what we're thinking. So we've done it gradually and I think that's worked quite well through the year. Yeah.
I think they'd have been a bit daunted being just chucked on the playground with all the big straight away.
And it was a parent concern. A lot of parents said, "Oh, we're a bit concerned about the lunch times and the play times." And they're still doing play times on the nursery. They don't do playgrounds, but they don't actually do a play time as such. Mm. It tends to be part of their learning a bit more like nursery.
Right.
So Mrs. Riley and Mrs. Hodgkiss go out with them at a certain time, just to get breaks in for staff as well, really. But it's not a play time as such. But then lunch time it is, and that seems to be working quite well. Yeah. Anyway. Thank you very much. Thank you for your time and thank you for your comments.
Okay.